Steelers and Titans game has officially been postponed to later in the season.
There goes my fantasy team.
Yeah, your fantasy team. Zito talked about this earlier. He's got Roethlisberger starting quarterback. Derrick Henry is starting running back.
Mm-hmm. And Pornhub. It was. We're going down.
All right. And after a COVID outbreak in the Tennessee Titans facility, one day after playing the Minnesota Vikings. First, it was three players, five personnel. Then it became four players, five personnel. What? And then as of this morning, I believe it became five players, what? Five personnel, because COVID-19 can incubate in your body for a few days. And yesterday we talked to Shefty, and Shefty told us that the look would be for potentially Monday or Tuesday, depending upon if more positive tests came back or not. So if it was just the three and then the one extra one of the four and the five personnel, and it remained just those nine, I believe the NFL's idea was, okay, then we got it contained, we keep them out of here. But now that another positive came, or another two positives came today, Shefty said that they would probably make the decision to delay the game or postpone the game further down the road. So now we're at a position where the Pittsburgh Steelers, who are undefeated, they're getting hot. Ben Roethlisberger's figuring out how to play Ben Roethlisberger football again. The defense is still dominant. A massive AFC game after the Titans came back from being behind against the Minnesota Vikings on Derrick Henry's shoulder. Now the Steelers have to take their bye week here in week four, their week eight bye week, which is, hello, we just hit Yahtzee on the bye week schedule game for right in the middle of the season. So the Steelers will have a bye week now in week four without really being told that they had a bye week. So it's not really a bye week. And I do believe they're still going to have to get tested. So they're not going to be able to go anywhere. So does a bye week really matter in 2020? I guess not. But the Steelers now have a week four bye week, as do the Titans, and they'll postpone it later. Everybody assumes that the way to do this would be the Steelers play the Ravens in week eight. The Ravens have a bye in week eight. NFL could very easily move Ravens-Steelers to week eight and put Steelers-Titans in week seven, because I believe that's when the Titans bye week is. So that makes sense. It actually kind of worked out for them to be able to reschedule it. Sucks for the Steelers, who in this particular case have nothing in their building or any other things happening. And obviously sucks for the Titans, because I assume they didn't want to have this happen to them, but it did. It has now been moved to further along in this season. Everybody seems to think that the Steelers and Titans will play instead of this week. The Steelers and Titans will take their bye week this week. The Titans have a bye week week seven. The Steelers have a bye week week eight originally scheduled. So what they're thinking happens here is, boom, let's go ahead and have the Steelers play the Ravens. Or no, let's move the Ravens-Steelers games to week eight instead of the Steelers having a bye week then. And let's move the Steelers-Titans to week seven, because that's when the Titans are supposed to have their bye week. Steelers-Titans week seven, Steelers-Ravens week eight. Got a bye week in the fourth week of the season for both Steelers and Titans. It doesn't matter what COVID does. We'll be able to figure it out. That seems to be the right move, which everybody is kind of leaning towards. We talked about it yesterday. But that Monday Night Football CBS game would have been awesome to watch. I don't know how that would have went. But the reason why they're moving it is because yet another positive has come out of the Tennessee Titans organization today. They're probably assuming another one's going to come. And the no practice thing, even though they said they do not care about competitive fairness in the world that we're currently in, whether it's fans being in the stands, people being able to get through a season, losing some people. Hey, we're doing what we got to do to get through the season. Now they are saying we should postpone this thing, because who knows how fair it actually is in a league that revolves around parity, allegedly. You would have to have some fairness.
Yeah, and getting the Ravens after, or no, getting a bye after the Ravens would have been nice. And now playing the Ravens after a bye is probably going to be tough after you play a team like the Tennessee Titans, who like to ram it down your throat. And probably going to be a little sore after that one.
And we do have some statements coming out from the Pittsburgh Steelers. Mike Tomlin just had a press conference, and they asked him about now having to play 13 straight games because his bye week has moved from week eight to week four. And Mike Tomlin, to quote, says, "We do not care." Mike Tomlin doesn't have to hit anybody, obviously, but Mike Tomlin is this type of coach. Nobody talks about Mike Tomlin enough, by the way. He is a guy who wins a lot of games, and whenever it goes wrong just a little bit, everybody's calling for him to get fired. He wins games with bad teams. He wins games with good teams. Mike Tomlin is a great football coach, and he is a no bullshit, no nonsense coach, and it doesn't get talked about a lot. He does not care about anything that's going on. he cares about football. That is all Mike Tomlin cares about. He loves the city of Pittsburgh. He goes out to Penguins games. I see him in town whenever I go out. He is a guy, though, that is only focused on football. You keep all the other bullshit out of this building. We do not care. We are playing football. And whenever he is asked to give a quote about something, he's always very intelligent with what he says, and he's always along the same exact lines, which is, I do not care. Just like he just said here, we do not care. He's your classic football guy. If we got to play in a parking lot, we'll play in a parking lot. If we got to do this, we'll do this. If you want us to do this, we'll do this. We do not care. We just want to play ball. That's why Pittsburgh and Mike Tomlin have had so much success together. And it's also why I think people should talk about Tomlin a little bit more, because the guy's been consistent as hell, and he's a savage. Mike Tomlin is an absolute savage, and I enjoy the hell out of him.
As far as coaches that this could happen to, Vrabel and Tomlin are up near the top that will handle it best. But yeah, the only knock on Tomlin is, we've talked about this with defensive coaches before, is potentially sometimes game situations get a little out of control.
Whoa, Tony.
I think his sideline attire is top three in a league.
Oh, great.
Unbelievable.
Top three in a league, okay? He always looks incredible.
Aviators on point.
Very comfortable. He swags a little bit during the games, which I appreciate. He daps people up. He gets in there, and he just loves the football. I don't know the situational awareness. I guess I don't follow along as much as possible. Does he fuck those up?
Every once in a while, but like it's amplified when he does it for some reason. I mean, the guy's never had a losing season in 50, however long he's been there. Like, I mean, that's pretty good.
I'd say he's Super Bowl.
Not bad.
I'd say that's pretty good. I mean, the guy, and he's had to deal with, by the way, now hindsight we know.
Yeah, a lot of.
Now hindsight we know, with people who have been in that locker room or no longer in that locker room, he was potentially going against something that, what, three other places could not handle or do. So it's, I mean, he is a guy that doesn't get enough credit. But you're right, him and Vrabel, same exact dudes. Like, okay, we just got to show, we got to walk through and we'll play. You would never hear them even back down from that type of
thing. Yeah, but that one time he stepped 6 inches onto the field and almost got in the way of Jacoby Jones, people act like he took a crowbar to his knee.
He almost did.
Sideline.
He did do that on purpose, though, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Which is very obvious.
You want your coach to do.
And by the way, yeah, I think in the locker room they're like, did you see fucking T?
And Tomlin's had to deal with two of the most revolutionary quarterbacks in the past 20 years with Lamar Jackson, footsteps Flacco.
And the AFC North is a problematic place, though.
Yeah.
Aside from your point about Joe Flacco, who has won a Super Bowl.
Footsteps. Yeah.
Just surgical in the playoffs.
But the AFC North is not like exactly a fun place to coach for 15 years. I mean, that is – is that how long he's been there?
I'll check.
Like a stat. That's a long ass time.
Four?
Can I get your thoughts real quick on the game being postponed and the Steelers being basically forced into a bye week here without knowing it, and then potentially they're going to lose their bye week later and it's going to change back and all that? They get a week four bye, and then they're supposed to have a week eight bye, but the Titans have a week seven bye, so they're going to push the game between the Steelers and the Ravens from week seven to week eight. And then they're going to play the Titans in week seven, which is where the Titans bye is. So now the Steelers and Titans take their bye now. This is probably what they're going to do. This has not been officialized, but this seems to make the most sense. Not that the most sense always wins in these particular situations, but if you're a player and you get told on a Thursday, hey, this is your bye week now, what is your mindset? And do you have to just be like, at this point, it's 2020, like this type of shit's going to happen?
Exactly. I feel like coming into this season, guys kind of prepared for, you know, the unexpected. And you knew it wasn't going to be a fair season. Nothing about this season was going to be normal. I'm sure everybody has some type of contingency plans when it came to this. But as a player, you just got to be ready to play. And I saw that they were saying earlier the guys would just be able to watch film and not even be able to go in the facility and go out there and play. That would have obviously been unfair. But as a player, you just got to do what you got to do, especially with a year like this, with everything that's going on. The sooner you know, just like you know, the sooner you know what the plan is, the better you can prepare and be mentally and physically ready to play. But that early bye week sucks. We know nobody wants a bye week in week four, especially if you've been anticipating one in week eight, which would have been perfect. So it sucks for them, but I'm sure they'll adapt and, you know, make it happen.
The importance of a bye week is understated. People come back as if it's an off season, but like that, it almost has a feeling as if guys just had like 3 months off, because you're getting, you get into this routine every day. Groundhog's Day. The NFL is Groundhog's Day. It's just the same day, one after another. Here we go. And not for me, but for guys that are hitting people and having to study, like they have to study just as much as kids that are in school even more so. So it's just like the hitting, the studying, the grind, the this, the treatment, the rehab, the this, the that. And then you get a break in that for like 5 days and guys just get to like go home or travel or whatever. Now they wouldn't be able to do that this year, but even just get out of that routine for a little bit, yep. Watch some TV. When guys come back, there's this renewed energy. There's like, hey, where'd you go? There's stories as if it was a fucking off season. There's just like a, hey, here we go. And now like, that's the word. The thing that I feel bad for most is the Steelers players that didn't know they had a bye week right now. So they didn't even get a chance to be like, hey,
didn't
even get a chance to shut it off just for a couple of days. Cause that's a very important thing now that we're learning more and more about mental health. But I think the importance of a bye week doesn't get talked about enough for an entire team's energy. In a week 4 bye week, absolutely sucks. I mean, it's like, well, now you got 13 weeks on the back end here. You gotta go.
Exactly. And the Steelers, you know, I think they'll be in the playoffs this year. So you'll see them having a long season. So you got a week 4 bye week, and then you got, you know, 12, 14, 15 more weeks straight, which is brutal, especially when you're living in a place and it's cold. That makes a difference, too.
No, Pittsburgh's a dream.
That makes a difference. When you're in the cold, I know for me it did. When you're in a cold city, you're looking for, you got that bye week circle. You're looking at the schedule, you got that bye week circle, and it's like a whole new season, like you said, coming out on the other side of that. So they can't get away on vacation, obviously, but now to not even have that bye week, blinders. Put your blinders on. Keep chopping away. And just focus on what's in front of you, Pittsburgh. You guys got it.
Hey, remember, you're not a human.
Excuses.
Remember, you're not a human. So we don't want to hear shit about you being sore, okay? You are getting paid a lot of money. So the thought that you even want to, you want a break? Get the fuck out of here. We don't even want to hear it, pal.
There's no wall, yep. But I mean, you know, it is what it is, man. 2020, it's been a battle. It's been a challenge for everybody, man. So I don't think, you know, people feel sorry for them. They shouldn't feel sorry for themselves. And, you know, we're football players. We adapt. And whatever it is, we got to go out there, roll it out, and play, man.
What did Chuck Pagano what did Robert Mathis tell Chuck Pagano? There ain't no pity parties in
the NFL. Yeah, ain't no pity parties in the NFL, man. That carries on. That is what it is.
We had a loss. I forget what it was. And it was like a very quiet locker room or whatever. And Chuck was like, Robert, you got him or whatever. And Robert goes, all right. There ain't no pity parties in the NFL. Team on three. 1, 2, 3. Two. That's exactly right.
All right. On to the next one.
Well, good. I guess you're fucking right. I mean, I hope we win next week because I'll tell you what, there'll be a lot of pity in this son of a bitch.
Sucks.